Time, family, friends. It's a deal of deals. It's beautiful days to spend love for. Hearts are for timing. Love for our time. Our thoughts and our feelings, our congratulations for our portfolio. May be blessed with a beautiful day. And as of this moment for the next few minutes, let's put aside all personal home thoughts, family thoughts, just think of time and bring them to the forefront of our mind as we pray with all our faculties, the love that they have, that will bloom from both from strength to strength. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. The Lord be with you all. As yet, the lives of Tara, Christopher Villalobos, and of Tammy and Robin have been their own. Their destinies, as at this moment, are still separate. But after today, things will be very definitely changed. Their lives will be linked together. They will be bound to one another. And during this ceremony, they remind themselves to one another by a very special bond. Bond that we call marriage. God blesses this bond, and God's wish for Tammy, for Todd, and our wish for both of them is this bond that will last forever and ever. We are human, very, very human. And oftentimes through weakness, through selfishness, we may be still tempted sometimes to give up on movement. So let us today, in our own way, each in his own way, each in our own way, reach out and ask God to help poor Tammy and Todd, that they may be true to the promises and that they may be faithful to one another. Let us pray. Heavenly Father, hear our prayers now for Todd and for Tammy. Bless the covenant of love that they are entering as of this moment. See the bond of marriage by which they are no longer true, but one in mind and one in heart. Bind them closely to you and to one another. We do not ask that this bond will never be tested, but only that it will be strong enough to endure whatever comes. We ask this prayer through Christ our Lord. Would you please now be seated in the wedding party of the high priestess?
Remove our sins. The Lord is compassionate and love.
Father of compassion on his children, the Lord is pity and most fearing. For he knows what we are needing. He remembers that we are dust. The Lord is compassion and love. The love of the Lord is everlasting on those who fear him. His justice never reaches out to his children. When they keep his covenant of truth, the Lord is compassion and love. And our second reading, also from the New Testament, is St. Paul's letter to the Corinthians from the beautiful chapter on love. If I speak in the tongues of men and of angels and have not love, I am a noisy gong or a clanging cymbal. And if I have prophetic powers and understand all mysteries and all knowledge, and if I have all faith so as to remove mountains, but have not love, I am nothing. If I give away all I have, and if I deliver my body to be burned, but have not love, I gain nothing. Now this is not jealous or boastful. It's not arrogant or rude. Love is not insistent on its own way. It's not irritable or resentful. It does not rejoice in harm. It rejoices in the right. Love bears all things, believes all things, hopes all things. Love never fails. This is the word of God. Would you please now stand and accept for our gospel reading is taken from St. John's Gospel, chapter 15, verses 9 to 12. Now Jesus said to his disciples, "As the Father has loved me, so have I loved you. Abide in my love. If you keep my commands, you will abide in my love, just as I have kept my Father's commands and abide in his love. These things I have spoken to you, that my joy may be in you, and that your joy may be full. This is my command, that you love one another as I have loved you." Gospel. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Would you please have a seat? rather they wish one another upwards and upwards and upwards. Now here in San Diego, today, all over the country, all over the world, people are getting married. We can usually say they are tying the knot. And when we say they are tying the knot, we acknowledge that a bond has been formed between two people. Like it or not, from that moment forward, from that day forward, their lives are linked together. Their destinies are inextricably bound up with one another. In a word, they are like timers on the moon.
Tyler and Tammy,
guarantee the cause of their fathers and mothers. We are indebted to our parents for so very, very much. And so as his mom and his mom, the Diaz of the family, show their commitment to themselves and to the future children who will be born of this relationship, they now are making commitment to pass on, as they have learned from their parents, they're going to teach their own children. So in that spirit, we'd like to ask Todd and Tammy to come forward. And light to bring kind of symbolizing love for your parents and your love for one another.
Stays united with her husband Todd in the sacrament of marriage.
ask this to Christ our Lord. Prayer, let's read the books and time and part of our way. This comes easy to church, this comes easy to me. Lord, we will share with time and time the love of one another. We need to be not paid.
Thank you. Could you get a little closer to the car? I almost stepped into the curb there, okay, without getting hurt.
Okay,
I'm fine. Todd, you follow her to her.
Okay. Get into the curb. Okay.
Well, I live over by water right there.
No pressure. I love that.